I never knew that I had any kind of talent. I just wanted to do it. What I really do is to do it. But what I like to do is to do the thing I want to do. And then when it's finished, it just doesn't seem important to me anymore. I thought at one time I might become a great portrait painter, and I liked doing portraits. I realized two or three times in my life I could always make a living painting portraits. But my patience with people was short. I discovered that I was better off painting pictures that nobody wanted than to be painting portraits that only a few wanted, you see. Person in the world is he who stands the most alone. That means a great deal to me, because I think that if something is worth standing for, one stands alone for it. I'm still learning. I've been on a self-imposed high all my life. I see no reason to take it easy. You know, a day to me is the most glorious thing that I can work on. And I am ashamed if I don't fill it well. So it doesn't take anything to stimulate me. It is my studio, my home. I live here year-round. I work here year-round. I can tell you right now, it was the funniest looking mess you ever saw when we moved in. I loved the idea that was planted here. It looked implacable as long as it wasn't converted too much. I didn't want it clean and neat and perfect.
I have no wish for a more polished existence. You know, in my way of life, I've learned to enjoy this kind of isolation.
Big cities don't appeal to me. They have a, they're a distraction from morning till evening. New York holds anything for me, for my art. That's really the very truth of it. I don't think the shadows could be born in New York. That may be my ultimate downfall. The fact that I didn't feel the need to join that kind of lifestyle. I really am almost a staid, conservative Chester Countyan, basically. As New York would view it, probably. The finding of the voice is a very, very It's not a singular event. It happens in a transitional sense. The first voice I may have heard would have been in 1951 when I did a painting that was what I felt was a pure shadow. The seeing of the possibilities and the potentials of shadows came much earlier than the actual doing of them. It took me then 20, 30 years to realize that the shadow could only move as a silhouette and a shadow if it were larger. So that the small things I did in that day, for economic reasons, were simply not saying what I wanted them to say. But the idea was there. Now we had the idea, and we're going with it, and we're struggling to make people accept it. But people could hardly accept it if it wasn't perfected.
I used to be terribly sensitive. No more. Gosh, no. I kind of take it. I mean, as far as art criticism and stuff goes, I don't care whether they like it or not. It's not going to change. There it is. That's what they get. What you see is what you get. And I worked very hard to get it, and I'm not going to change it.
I'm not an unpatriotic soul, but neither am I patriotic. I think that any place the Lord would have placed me, any place on this earth, I would have done just as well to irritate most people and to, at the same time, get along with others. When I want to make sport of myself, I do something absurd like that, but just something so critical.